Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the electrical power transmission course. Today I am going to explain about the performance of single phase short transmission line. For balanced three phase system, the voltage and current remains same in each phase. Therefore, it is convenient to represent the three phase into its equivalent single phase representation for performance calculations. In the previous lecture, we have discussed that the effect of line capacitance are neglected for a short transmission line. Therefore, while studying the performance of short transmission line, only resistance and inductance of the line are taken into account. The equivalent circuit of a single phase short transmission line is shown in the figure 1. Here, the total line resistance and inductance are shown as concentrated or lumped instead of being distributed. It may be noted that the circuit is a simple AC series circuit. Let I is the load current, R is the loop resistance, XL is the loop reactance, VR is the receiving end voltage, cos phi R is the receiving end power factor, VS is the sending end voltage, cos phi s is the sending end power factor. Now the phasor diagram of the line for lagging load power factor is shown in the figure 2. From the figure it may be noted that current I is taken as the reference phasor. OA represents the receiving end voltage VR leading I by phi R. AB represents the drop IR in phase with I. BC represents the inductive drop IXL and leads I by 90 degree. OC represents the sending end voltage VS and leads I by phi S. From the right angled triangle ODC we get OC square is equal to OD square plus DC square. Putting the values of OD and DC we get the following expression. Putting the values of OE, ED, DB and BC, we get the following expressions. Simplifying the above expression, we get the following expression. Now, the percentage voltage regulation for single phase short transmission line is given by the following expression. From the figure, the sending end power factor becomes equal to the OD upon OC. Putting the values of OD and OC, we get the sending end power factor as below. Now, power delivered or received will be equal to the following expression. And the line loss are given by I square R. Therefore, power sent out will become equal to the receiving end power plus losses. Putting the expressions of receiving end power and losses, the final expressions for sending end power will become as below. The percentage transmission efficiency for short transmission line is given by the following expression. These all are the expressions that may be used to calculate the sending, receiving, voltage, power, voltage regulation, losses and efficiency of the short transmission line. Now I am going to discuss how short transmission line can be represented through complex notation. It is often convenient and profitable to make the line calculation in complex notation. Taking VR as the reference phasor, draw the phasor diagram as shown in the figure. It is clear that VS is the phasor sum of VR and IZ. Here, phasors are shown by arrows and their magnitude without arrow. Thus, VR with arrow is the receiving end voltage phasor, whereas VR is its magnitude. Mathematically, voltage phasor VR is given as below and current phasor is given as below. Here, angle is taken as negative or in other words, conjugate is taken. This is necessary to represent the lagging nature of the power system. It is because majority of the load in the power system is inductive in nature. In inductive load, current lags behind the voltage, therefore it is taken as negative. It is necessary, otherwise calculations will be wrong. From the figure, it can be observed that Z is equal to R plus JXL and VS is equal to VR plus IZ. Putting the values of VR, I and Z, we get the following expression. Simplifying it, we get the following expression. Taking the magnitude, we get the following expression. The second term under the root is quite small and can be neglected with reasonable accuracy. Therefore, the approximate expression for Vs becomes as below. It may be noted that this approximate formula for Vs gives fairly correct results for lagging power factors. However, appreciable error is caused for leading power factors. Therefore, approximate expression for Vs should be used for lagging power factor only. Friends, in this lecture, I have discussed about the performance of single-phase short transmission line. I have derived the various expressions for sending end voltage, sending end power, receiving end power, losses and efficiency of short transmission line for its performance calculation. That's all for today's lecture. I hope you really enjoyed this lecture. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.